I'll tell you what, bottom of the fourth, Jack, took 31 minutes, seven batters reached before the first out was even recorded. Eight hits, eight runs. It was the continued succession of hitting early in the counts, too, on rolling, breaking balls, pitches that clearly weren't good. They got the Yankees into a lot of trouble.
Yeah, Holder just did not have his stuff, and you're right, Bob. Some of these hits occurred early in the count, which obviously impacts what the Yankee thinking is going on in the dugout, but even if you say, okay, Pierce's home run, you're going to give him one more batter because you don't really have anybody ready in the bullpen. After J.D. Martinez's double, you just have to figure out a way to kill some time. Even if he has to try and make pickoff attempts to second base five times in a row, I know there's gamesmanship, sportsmanship, whatever you want to call it. Every manager in baseball history and every pitching coach, they figured out a way to kill some time until you can get that next pitcher ready. The Yankees didn't have Green ready. As you and I said, I think they were trying to stay away from Green and Sessa to a certain degree. They end up using both of those guys. And, Bob, we haven't even discussed Chad Green is probably your choice ahead of Holder. David Cone brought this up, too. It's a high-leverage situation. You could have brought in Green to start the fourth as opposed to Holder. But, again, I think the Yankee plan was let's get maybe two innings out of Holder, then go to Green, then go to your big guys, Robertson, Britton, Betances, Chapman. The Yankees never even got a chance to get there. This game gets way away from them, and it's the worst possible way to start a big four-game series where you wanted to send a message to the Red Sox. The reverse happened. They send an emphatic message to the Yankees.
And there is a reason that the Red Sox wanted Steve Pearson this lineup. He's very good within the division, so they traded for